Welcome back viewers. In this video lecture we are going to discuss about single phase induction motors. First of all we will see that what is a single phase induction motor. We can define the single phase induction motor like that. It is a type of motor that converts a single phase AC power into mechanical power. Further, there are different types of single phase AC single phase induction motors, such like that split phase induction motor, capacitor start induction motor, AC series or universal induction motor. First of all we will go through split phase induction motor in details. So as you can see in this picture that this is a rotor of a split phase induction motor. So we can describe the internal construction of split phase induction motor like that. In split phase induction motor, the stator winding is divided into main winding and stator winding to split the single phase AC in two phases for RMF generation. So as you can see in this picture, the rotor of the split phase AC, so as here you can see there is a main winding and another there is a stator winding, so which help us to split the single phase AC into two phases. So that will help us to generate a particular RMF. Further, split phase AC, the windings are made such like that the stator winding is highly resistive. It means that which will help us to pass the minimum supply current, and the next main winding is made highly inductive, which will help us to maximize or which will help us to produce maximum current, and that will result as a large flux. After that, here is the circuit of a split phase induction motor. So here you can see that it is the stator winding and it is the main winding, and here there are particular terms like IM, it is the main winding current, IS, it is the stator winding current, and VIN will be the supply voltage, or VIN will be the supply AC power. And here you can see that there will be a particular phase difference between the IS and IM. Now it is the phasor diagram of split phase AC, split phase induction motor. So first of all we will say that phasor difference or the alpha between IM and IS will be equal to 25 degrees, and the starting torque can be calculated using this formula. And here as you can see in this circuit, so we will be using a centrifugal switch to disconnect the stator winding when the motor achieves the particular, or we can say 75% of its rated speed. There are further different characteristics of split phase. The first one is the torque is 1.5 to 2 times of full load torque, and the next IS or stator current is 6 to 8 times of full load current. And these are the split phase AC motors are low cost, and the power rating of split phase are 60 watts to 250 watts, and we can use them such like in fans, washing machines or oil burners. The next type of this induction motors is that single phase induction motor is that capacitor start induction motor. In capacitor start induction motors, the stator winding is divided into main winding and stator winding, but there is an addition with the starter winding. We add an capacitor in series with the stator winding. As you can see in this picture, this is the main winding and this is the stator winding, and here we are adding a capacitor in series with the stator winding. So that will help us in different ways, which will be discussed further. First of all, as you can see here, IS will be the stator winding current, and I will be the input current, and IC will be the capacitor current, and alpha will be a particular phase difference between IS and IM. So as you can see in the phasor diagram of the capacitor start, so here you can see that the alpha between IS and IM is 80 degrees. So capacitor is inserted with starter winding to improve the power factor. The first use of the capacitor is that it improves the power factor of the motor, and starting torque of the motor. It will also increase the starting torque of the motor. The value of capacitor is so adjust that the given alpha should be 80%. That we will take a such type of capacitor value that the alpha between IS and IM should be 80 degrees. And similarly, we will use a centrifugal switch which will disconnect or which will disconnect the main winding, starter winding, when we achieve the 75% of the rated speed. Next, there are particular characteristics of capacitor type induction motor is that the starting current is off of the split phase. As you can see, that the current is decreased. Starting torque is greater than the split phase because of alpha. As you can see, that alpha is 80%, but in the first case, the alpha was nearly 25%. So here the alpha was 80 degrees. So we can see that which will help us to for a greater starting torque, and it is used for long starting period. Such machines which have long starting period, so we use the this type of induction motors there. And the power rating of such induction motor is that 120 watt to 7.5 kilowatts. We can see that the power rating is also increased. Next, we can use the such type of induction motors in compressors, large fans, pressure pumps, or other high inertia loads. The third type is AC series or universal induction motor. There is a quality of AC series induction motor that it can be used on DC and AC supply. For that purpose, we will use two switches, or we will use switches to split the supply for our DC or AC. And in AC series motor, the armature and the field winding are connected in series. As you can see in this picture, here you can see that it is field winding and it is the armature. So if you check the connection, it is such like that these two are in series with each other. And the next is that it works in a particular method, that when AC is the supply, the condition is that when we provide a AC supply to this motor, so it produces I, or the current produces a flux in the starter and the field winding. So here you can see that in starter, the starter current or this current will produce a flux in the field winding. The same current flows in the armature. It is the quality that at the time the same current also flows in the armature, and due to which the torque is produced. And similarly, when we provide a DC supply to this motor, here the flux is produced produced in the field winding, and the torque is produced according to the Fleming's left hand rule. As you can see here, it will be the magnetic field induction, you have magnetic field lines, and it will be the direction of current, so the produced force will be in this direction. Next, there are particular different characteristics of AC series induction motors. The speed range is 1500 to 15,000 RPM. So here you can see that it has a particular good RPM, or the speed range is good, and it has a high starting torque. And the power factor is 90%. Keep in mind that the power factor for the AC series induction motor is 90%. That increases the usages. For example, it is used in high speed vacuum cleaners or some other like drill machines, and it is also used in air coolers. So thanks for watching.